For the past 4 or 5 years, I've had a couple of different little drones to fly around on different holidays that we've gone on. This one particularly, this shot, is coming from New Zealand, flying up over Mount Cook. Loved flying the drone around the place, taking it out in the boat, getting some aerial shots of us cruising around there, different holidays overseas, and more recently when I've had the chance to take the drone up to take some photos of construction work out on the projects that I've been doing, flying along the side of machinery, getting some overhead shots of different project progress, and also seeing completions of some of the work that we've been getting done, led me to a point where I wanted to see how to take this hobby and actually formalize it and go through the steps and stages to be able to get my recognized CASA drone license. So I'm gonna run you through step by step how I converted my fixed wing commercial pilot license to our CASA approved REPL remote pilot license. So follow along, I'll show you, and here's a few clips to just illustrate what it's like out during the training. So first of all, typically with your remote pilot license training, you'll sit 5-day course. So for people that don't have an existing RPL, PPL, or CPL, they'll have to do a theory component. Conversion pathway is only done by a few different operators around the country, but essentially what it does, it takes out all of the theory. So you just go on a couple of days, log up some flight hours with the drone. I was lucky enough to sort of have a couple of hours logged in my DJI app, which meant that it was pretty easy to be able to get out there and, you know, play around with some of the Phantoms and the other drones they had there that the guys were training with. On the day, I had to show, or on the couple of days that we were doing the flights, I had to show my pilot license, which was the digital copy that I had on my phone, and then obviously my ID. Then head out to the field in pairs, pick up one of the older Phantom drones and perform a heap of training, doing different laps around the sets of cones that were laid out on this paddock that we were, or this field that we were working from near Brisbane. Started with just drawing a simple box and then going sort of laterally and around the different cones. Sort of end the first day with figure eights and taking the drone in and around the cones to be able to demonstrate that you've got pretty good handling technique. The second day, come back, refine some of the handling techniques on the two different drones, and then it was time to sort of step up and go and do a little practice flight and then a flight test with the class that we're going for the RPL. This was the sub 25 kilo multi-rotor pilot license, we're obviously training with Aviation. Guys there are really helpful. The instructor is actually a fixed-wing commercial pilot from WA who's stayed in the industry by teaching people how to fly these drones and then doing the training component. Yeah, so the drone that we did the test, or the final flight test in, was a DJI Matrice 600, which weighs over 6 kilograms dry and will give you the endorsement for up to 25 kilos. The flight test consisted of sort of taking off, showing some general handling, drawing a box in the sky, and then flying it out of the little training area that we had set up, and getting to a point where you were sort of maybe unstable, you'd call it, or out of position mode, and then having to fly the drone back and land it safely in the little area that was set up with the cones. All in all, the conversion was a lot cheaper than having to sit the whole drone course. So I think it was ended up being $1,500 and only 2 days, rather than spending a full 5-day period doing the drone training, like the theory, sitting in a classroom and then heading out to the field. So, you know, if you're a commercial fixed wing pilot, or I'm sure it's the same with the rotors, you can take all that theory and use it as prior recognition of learning to head out to the paddock and do some basic handling and then a flight test. And then you can walk away with that remote pilot license, which allows you to operate and get paid for it, much the same as your commercial pilot license for a fixed wing or a heli. I found it pretty interesting going through it. Obviously, there's a lot of handling stuff that you don't pick up if you're just flying around a basic DJI in your backyard or for fun. So there were some really good things to learn out of there. Obviously, the other things that were interesting to learn about was flight planning and the overlap. It's all exactly the same as if you were going to take a flight through any sort of controlled airspace or near aerodrome. You've got to go through the same processes of taking off in those airspaces, which, you know, if you've done your commercial or even your private recreational, you understand that. Those things apply for drone pilots as well as normal airplanes. So after all of that, I walked away with an update endorsement for the sub 25 kilo remote pilot license. Pretty cool. I'll definitely use it for work and maybe some other bits and pieces in the future. So yeah, hopefully this helps sort of share some light on how you can convert your license over to the drone license. I've been wondering myself, so it might be something that's interesting. It's also interesting to see a fellow commercial pilot out there doing that training. His main comment was what he was earning training people how to fly the drones was going to be a lot more than what he could have earned as a grade 3 instructor or any other stuff there. Not to say it's anywhere near the same, but it's still in the aviation industry. So pretty cool in that respect. Yeah. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you next time.